Spy X Family is one of the most funniest, melt-your-heart shows of recent times, and for good reason. A few years ago, I stumbled upon the manga and was pretty intrigued. You got a Cold War-based setting, a spy, assassin, telepath, and even future-seeing dog, all under one roof. But as I continued to read through the manga, something hit me. Beneath the gags and hilarious misspellings, and Anya's love for peanuts, there's some deep, dark stuff. Spy X Family is kind of like Shrek, in some way. It's funny, but when you get older, you realize a lot of the other stuff you would never noticed. Except replace the adult jokes with some very, very beautiful messages. Now, to preface this, this type of story isn't all that strange. There's been countless iterations of strangers learning how to become a family. What's interesting is where it's coming from and how Endo is saying it. Really, the author is saying something I think is pretty relevant, especially to our day. Now, just a quick summary. Between the countries of Westalias and Ostania, peace is extremely fragile. An agent from Westalias named Twilight is tasked with a new mission. Keep the peace between the two nations by spying on someone named Donovan Desmond. The only way Twilight can get close, however, is through his son, who's enrolled at a prestigious academy. Twilight, aka Lloyd Forger, forms a fake family. Anya is a girl he picks up, and he doesn't realize this, but she can actually read minds. Yor, a famous assassin known as Thorn Princess, and later we get a future-seeing dog named Bond. Oh, and no one knows anyone's background, except for Anna, and she's like 4 or 5. She doesn't know what's going on, and that's kind of what makes it funny to see things through her perspective. Lloyd, who comes off as very strong, he knows what he's doing, he's a spy, he's done the craziest things, and he fits the stereotype as being the man of the house, someone who's got all the answers and tools. It kind of fits that what a father should be. But what's funny in the twist is he can't figure out what is happening. None of his missions are going right. Even with his years of experience as a legendary spy, nothing seems to be working out with this new operation. Now, we have Yor, the assassin, and she kind of fits the stereotype as being shy and dismissive, and doesn't even know what's going on. Interesting is, there's a kind of a twist on it. She's a total BA, and she's terrible at housework. And then we got Anya, who is stereotyped as, you know, the kid that doesn't know anything. She knows everything that's happening because she can read minds. What's all interesting about these main three characters is that they embrace their familial roles to a certain degree, but aspects of them say, hey, I don't really fit in this mold. And they struggle with this, even Anya. And so it's this juggling of societal roles, personal missions, and journeys of self-discovery that what takes Spy X Family from a pretty funny manga into a pretty funny manga that's actually meaningful. That, oh, I'm actually learning something from this. So what is Spy X Family actually asking? And it asks two really important questions. One, what does it mean to be part of a family? What does it mean to be a family member? Two, what is the ideal family? When you think about it, you have a Japanese author writing about a family in a Western country, and they got me analyzing all of that. And it's interesting because right now in Japan, the meaning of family has evolved drastically in the last few years. People aren't getting married. Obviously, there's a family revolution happening right now in Japan, but it's not just there, it's in the whole world. Working from home, a change of work-life balance, changing family roles, even LGBTQ+, there's a whole lot happening that's changing the meaning of what does it mean to be part of a family. Here's what I've deduced from Spy X Family. One, what does it mean to be a family member? So we have a huge emphasis on responsibility. We have Anya, who believes, hey, my role is saving the world. Lloyd, remember Twilight, his thing is get the mission done, but you find out later it's really to save childhood. You find out a lot more, but I won't spoil anything. And then we have Yor, and what's interesting about Yor is she focuses more on how can I be a good mom and hide my assassination work. And one thing that is a little sad is Yor actually is trying to figure out her responsibility. From Yor's backstory, you learn she really didn't know what her purpose was because her purpose was only in raising her brother. Everyone has different responsibilities and missions that they want to accomplish. It's this conflict, this battle between familial responsibility and one's own mission that's explored. It almost, in a sense, answers this conflict, this tension, answers, hey, this is what qualifies me to be a family member. Over the course of the story, we see tiny changes that happen to each family member that kind of expand upon this. Lloyd, Twilight especially, he starts to put his responsibilities as being an agent, as saving the world, and realizing, hey, this family that I'm a part of has equal weight to my role as a spy. There's something more to life than my own personal vendetta or my own feelings of getting something done. It's okay with getting little things done, seeing Anya smile, or you're being happy. And you're is starting to see, hey, there's more to life than just assassination work. I can do something else. We see that these members of the Forger family realize that there is a sacrifice that comes, that the bonds that hold people together aren't happening because of a label. And they shouldn't happen because you share the last name. The qualifications for being part of a family and for those bonds to be valid is when we begin to prioritize the happiness and well-being of others. When we begin to enjoy the company of others and do all we can to see them smile. Now, of course, like, that's something I think a lot of people kind of come into, that, hey, being part of a family is sacrifice of some sort, and sacrifice shows love. And what's interesting is, in Japanese culture, right, there's a big emphasis on sacrifice. And I think Endo is really kind of reminding us that that's not a bad thing, you know? We can obviously see, hey, there's a sacrifice in the story for spies for the peace of between these two countries of Westalias and Astania. And also, like, in our current time, right, there's been this shift away from sacrifice into staying within ourselves, to not give as much as we used to. In that sense, I think he's making some commentary that we as people really thrive when we do give to others. You know, we can be individual people, yet at the same time contribute to a single cause, to be part of a group and yet still be an individual. What's the ideal family? Maybe is it really that the family that sacrifices everything for each other? People that fit their roles and are just cogs in the machine? But no, right? Spike's family is really good at showing that no family is perfect, and that's what makes an ideal family. You are a part of a family when you're sacrificing for others, but you're still your own self. And it's those mistakes you make and growing from them that builds those bonds. It's that embracing the awkwardness. It's the rejecting the societal ideals and instead setting personal family goals and striving to achieve them. That's what makes the plot of getting Anya into school so interesting. The Forger family always gets where they're supposed to be, even if that's not the most conventional way. And that's also what makes the manga so fun. No one wants to read something that's predictable. You see that this family is doing everything wrong, yet they are moving forward. The meaning of family doesn't lie within a word. It's really built upon action, mistakes, discovering your own path, embracing the awkward juggle of your own needs, wants, as well as the needs and wants of others. There's no ideal family, and that's ideal. Maybe in your current circumstances, you don't have a standard family. Perhaps you're alone, perhaps there's some distance. What's beautiful is family is what you make of it. It all starts with you. It's a lot of responsibility, but it's exciting. I think Spy X Family is popular right now for a reason. It's funny and charming, but also written with heart. It connects to a lot of people because it reminds them, hey, sometimes we might feel a stranger in our own home, but there's nothing wrong with that. It takes time. It takes effort and sacrifice. Events will occur, though, sometimes bring you closer and sometimes farther. But it's the beauty of being in a family and taking the time to notice those bonds that you can really sit down and say, hey, even though the worst may come to worse, we will be sticking it through. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. I'm hoping to continue to make more content like this. Just you wait.